Good morning, children. So in previous class, we were learning how much food is important for us and what exactly ingredients are called as and from which type of animal or plant do we get the food. So today, we are going to learn how people develop the food habits. Means, in each and every state, there are different people who stay. And they have their own habit of eating the food. Suppose here you can see in Hyderabad, it's very famous for this biryani. Everyone will eat the rice. So, but in the northern side, right? In Delhi or Uttar Pradesh, this northern side and all, they mostly eat the chapati. So, how do people develop their own food habit? People living in one region usually share common food items. You might have seen paddy fields near your village. In our state, geographical and climatic conditions are more suitable for growing a paddy. So we eat more rice. Why do we eat more rice? Because in our area, it's very easy to grow a paddy. That is, our soil is so much suitable for growing a paddy. So that's why the people of Telangana will eat rice more. Even though farmers grow various types of crops, we generally use rice as a staple food. A variety of food items are prepared using the rice. We eat more rice and rice products as compared to the other cereals like wheat and maize. Yes, instead of eating chapati a lot, we prefer to eat rice a lot. But in Rajasthan, maize, bajra and wheat is produced more than rice. While in Rajasthan, they eat mainly chapatis and bajra a lot because they grow that type of crops. So that's why they eat their own food item, which is good. So the main food in Rajasthan is chapati or roti, we call it as. Many times we hear people saying that I like this curry, I don't like that. This is not a good habit. Now what? As you are in the home, so you are eating very varieties of food. If you are not willing to eat this, your mother might be preparing another food and coming, giving it. But when you come to the school, you know, in previous years also, there are students who will be telling, I don't want this curry, teacher, that's why I don't eat. It's a very good, bad habit. Even though if you are not willing to eat, you are supposed to eat. The reason is why it is good for your health. That's the reason your mother will cook that curry and send you, right? So you should be able to eat the curry which is made by your mother. So this is not a good habit. You should make a habit of eating all varieties of food, vegetable food items. This makes you wise. Why you are eating that? In order to make you strong and energetic. Now different methods of preparing food. So each food will be prepared in the same way. Suppose you are preparing chapati. You just need a maida. You will just put salt and you mix with water. And just you will rotate it. It will prepare like a chapati and you will put it on the top. In the same way, do you prepare rice? No. So each food has their own way of preparing. That's what he is saying. Preparing food is an extremely important art and essential for life. There are many ways of preparing food. Rice is boiled, but it is not made in the same manner. Potato chips are fried in oil. Some processes have been mentioned. Means distilling. As I told you, there are different types of food items. They are prepared in different varieties. That it is not possible that each food item which you prepare is in the same way. Right? It will be different. So, do you think whatever the food you prepare will be tasty? It might be tasty or it may not be tasty too. But we are supposed to eat the food which you have prepared because it's energetic. It doesn't mean that I prepare this food so I have to eat it. It's not like that. You prepare the food, it's the first time you lost. Next time you prepare, it might be tasting very tasty for them. Then you'll be able to eat the food, right? In the same way, we have to find extremely a different way to cook the particular food. It's like an art. Tasty food. We usually say food is tasty. But how does food get its taste? The taste of food depends upon the ingredients. facts. Do you know the method of preparing of any food item? Joseph knows how to make a tomato curry. Now there is a student. Now, as he is tasting, and I just told you, so how are you at home? So just give your mother afternoon or the night a holiday time. If not on Sunday, a holiday time. You can cook food for yourself and serve your mother. She'll be very happy to eat. If you're not able to, means you're not able to cook, ask her how to prepare. Ask her what are the ingredients we need for preparing the food, so that you can find the methods, and she will be helpful for you always. So you can find the methods, the way we cook the food. So you can write down the ingredients, what all you needed, and then you can start preparing the food. So try once at least at home, as you're at home. So it will be very easy to prepare the food. Now, let us cook. What is your favorite food? Find out how it is prepared. Write the recipe in your phone. As I told you, prepare the food and you'll be very happy. And you can also write comments about what your father said. About the food, what your father said, your mother, your sister, your brother, who are in the family. So, the first step, ask your mother what are the ingredients. The second step, ask how to prepare. Write the steps in your notebooks. And the third one is, write the comments of them also. Like how is the food, whether it is tasty or it is very bad. No problem, but always you get a good score. Now, how do we preserve a food? Discussion about food will be incomplete unless we talk about food preservation. Preservation is how do we store the food, how do we keep it. That is very, very important, right? How do farmers protect rice from pest and store it after it is harvested? How is the rice stored in the home? Why does curry get spoiled when kept out for a couple of days, but pickle stays fresh for so long? It is only because of preservation. You will have many questions, right? You will have many questions regarding the food. Suppose you got the food is spoiled, so you'll be very much angry, but you don't understand why it is exactly spoiled. So it is very important that the way we preserve the food, that is the only way we can protect that particular food for us to eat. For preserving certain food items, they are salted and dried. In certain areas, dried fish is commonly used. Vegetables and meat are dried and also pickled. Now, usually in villages, what do they do? They just dry all the vegetables and then prepare a pickle for that and store it in a bottle. Okay, they store it in a glass jar usually, right? And they store it in a different containers so to preserve it. Salt and turmeric powder are used for preserving while making pickles. In coastal areas, it's very common sight to see fish being smoked for preservation. Try to find out more about the process. What are the food materials preserved by this process? So let us store the food now. Discuss in groups and identify the examples of storing. Ask your parents other ways of preserving that they follow. Food preserving food. We use different types of preservatives, but some food items which are available in the market have harmful preservatives. So we must be aware of the ingredients of packaged food. When you purchase any item in the market, don't forget to read about its ingredients and manufacturing date. Eating outdated food material may damage your health. Now, till now we were learning how to prepare the food. What is the process? So, after preparing, you like the curry a lot. What the curry which you prepared, you liked it a lot. So, you want to preserve it for till night. So, ask your mother where to keep it, how to keep it, how to cover it. So, that she will give you the ideas. Right? So, that's the way you preserve the food and you will keep it storage. And you will be able to find out the ingredients which is becoming more tasty. Okay, that was a one way of preservation at home. But when it is outside, you will need all the stuff items which is outside, which is available. So when you are taking a particular packet, suppose you are buying a milk also, when you are buying it, after buying, check the manufacture date, till where, till what date it has to be used, right? So that is very, very important to children. Inside the house, what is prepared, that is your mother will be taking care. But when you're going outside and getting something and eating, it's very important that we should know what all the ingredients are being prepared with that, and what is there inside the packet, and what is the manufacture date, and what is the outdated. Outdated means till what date it is, it has to be used. So that suppose you are buying the chips packet, it is by tomorrow it's going to get outdated. So by today you have to eat. If not, it is outdated, you will be throwing it out. So if you eat that outdated foods, your stomach will be, it will be under constipation. So it is very, very important that it's very necessary that you have to check each and every item whatever you are buying from the outside. So I hope you understood the lesson of our food. So go through your lesson, read the entire lesson, and you have the keywords also in the lesson. So write the keywords and your lesson, as I told you, the notes have to be written. The notes is right regarding what all the animals from which animal, what type of food we get, and which plant from which plant, what type of food we get. Also, write a note what food items your ingredients you need and how it is a process, and write the comments of what your father